Hello, everybody, and welcome to the 10 Pin Bowling Show's telecast of the 2008 South Pacific Classic Women's Final. My name's Brenton Davey. Joining me in commentary, as usual, is Michael Tran. Good evening, Michael.
Good evening, Brenton. Today we have the Repechage Final. The first seed was defeated in last week's match, and just so that you know, we'll go back to last week's final just to see how we ended up.
And we come into the ninth frame. Bottom of the ninth frame, Carol Giannotti at this point in time, two closed frames, she would be the South Pacific Classic final.
And Carol comes into this match being the first seed. So coming into this match, all she needed to do was win, and she would be the champion.
That's right. And we see here the six pin doing his love tap on the 10 pin there. And at this point in time, all Carol needs to do is get up, throw any kind of a mark, and she would shut Anne-Marie out. Anne-Marie needing to win this tournament to give herself a chance of defending her World Cup title, which she won last year. So this is pretty tense stuff.
Absolutely.
But this lane had been giving Carol some problems, as it did there.
No, that was not a good shot by Carol, and she would love to have this ball again. She leaves the 4-6-7 standing, and all she can do really at this point is take two pins and hope that Anne-Marie gives her the win.
She'll be shooting. She goes to shoot for the two. Hope to bounce something out, but doesn't happen very often on these type of machines. But not all over yet, because then Anne-Marie Putney needed to get up in the 10th frame, throw two strikes and seven in order to give herself a chance of taking this to the repechage, because being the second seed, of course, she had to beat Carol twice.
It's very exciting stuff, and at this point in time, Anne-Marie's thinking, well, she needs to get the first one, and then she needs to do it again.
Now, partway through this match, she'd made a ball change on this lane. This lane had been giving her trouble. Ball hadn't quite been finishing. She went to a slightly more aggressive ball on this lane.
But, folks, check this out. Oh, we love that. And she did too.
She did. It would have been a hell of a way to lose. You know, go flush in the pocket like that, leave a cold nine.
No, she really didn't deserve go out fighting like that. The emotion there, getting that carry on the nine pin.
But she still needed to get up and throw at least one more good shot, and then follow that with good count.
Yeah, she has to at this point get up, throw another strike.
But as the reigning World Cup champion, you would have to think that, you know, she was going to get up and at least throw a good shot.
Good pocket shot, and well, that's all you can do as a bowler's perspective. The carry is another story. She puts in a very, very positive ball. Look at that is flush in the hole. 10 in the pin.
And under the pressure like that, you just really couldn't throw it any better than that. This is just a fantastic shot here under the pressure, given that the conditions had been pretty tough in this tournament. Get out, throw one that good. Now she needs a 7 count. Well, what do you do when you have to get 7? You try and hit the pocket. Don't try and do anything fancy.
No, I agree with you there. And for our reference viewers, our website is 10pinbowlingshow.com.au for all the information on our show.
And this was the money shot.
Ah, fabulous finish there by Anne-Marie Putney. She closes out for a 206 and takes this game into a one-match repechage.
And as a result of that victory last week, we had the repechage match. Carol Giannotti starting the match this time on the left-hand lane. And Carol's made a ball change.
Well, that's a very positive shot from Carol. You did pick up correctly there, Brenton. She did make a ball change. She likes to throw that inside line, doesn't she?
Oh, certainly her preferred angle. Very much her comfort zone, a little bit of a swing. There's Anne-Marie. Generally prefers playing straight up the boards, up the outside boards, which is unusual for most right-handers. They don't generally like getting out into that part of the world, but Anne-Marie does it better than anyone.
I'd have to agree with you there. And she gets it out wider than most, plays straight up. Well, not too many people travel out that way, so you would think that that her line to the pocket is going to stay maintained for the longest possible time.
And she too gets up, opens up with a strike, and we're even after one frame.
But look at this, viewers. That is flush. That is as flush as they'll go. That would be, well, carrying from the last game. It'll be five in a row now, and she is looking very, very good.
Well, having come home the way she did, she's got to have the momentum. Carol's got to refocus. She's got to get her game and her head back together for this one. Anne-Marie at the moment just seems to have the momentum. Notice that she's still maintaining, using different balls on different lanes, because each ball gives her a slightly different reaction. The two lanes are obviously reacting differently.
Calling for that one to go down, and she gets it. Carries the 7-9 nicely.
And that really is about knowing your game and knowing your equipment. Knowing what your equipment does, the differences between your equipment, when to drag it out, when to leave it in the bag.
And she's thrown six in a row now, so she's feeling really, really good. Carol gets up, crosses over, and gets one back.
Put that one down very, very early. Normally likes to get the ball well out on the lane. That one was down early. And when you put the ball down very early, it grabs the lane early. And if it grabs the lane early, it's going to hook early. In that case, it crossed over. She got the Brooklyn strike. She's now got a double.
Even after two.
There you go.
There must be a little bit of pressure on this shot. Oh, and she's gone again. She'll take that one.
She will, but you can see by the look on her face, she's not comfortable with the reaction she's getting.
Definitely not comfortable. But that's two of the very best Brooklyn strikes, and you'll definitely take them in this pressure situation.
And that basically puts her 10 pins in front at the moment. If Anne-Marie saw that, two Brooklyns in a row, it'd be hard not to think to yourself, gee, I'm trying to win this to get back to the World Cup to defend my title there. Why is this happening? But Anne-Marie's a very mentally strong person. I don't think it'll affect her too badly.
Well, you get lucky counts all the time, don't you? Sometimes you may get a strike that...
No! My that's when it hurts. You've just had your opponent throw a couple of Brooklyns at you. You just go and absolutely bury it.
How did that not carry?
For a stone-cold 8-pin. That has got to hurt.
But look, this is the experience of Anne-Marie Putney. She just clapped it. She clapped it off. She said, good shot. Goes back, hoping to pick this spare up. And in the end of the day, she's only going to be a handful of pins down.
And Anne-Marie's one of the best spare shooters I've ever seen. She certainly was never going to miss that one.
Well, she's got to have a fair bit of confidence, Anne-Marie Putney, going into this next frame. She has her opponent that's thrown two Brooklyn hits, and clearly she's not quite sure where the shot's at. And Anne-Marie's thrown three very, very confident pocket shots, and she's looking very good.
Anne-Marie, she's lined up on both lanes. She's got the reaction worked out on both lanes with the two different balls. Carol, on the other hand, she's fishing. And at some stage, you would have to think that's got to jump up and bite her.
Yeah, Carol has to find a line, and find a line very, very quickly. Anne-Marie is not letting up. She's carried the 4-7 across. Jot that one down.
Yep. That one's crept a little bit high. The left-hand lane obviously hooking a little bit more than the right-hand lane, and on that particular occasion, leaked it just a hair high. But correct angle of entry, correct ball speed.
When it all matches up, it equals 10. Now let's see what Carol can do here. She's had a strike thrown at her, and herself not knowing quite where the shot's at, goes a little wider.
Now that time she got the ball out on the lane, and it was like the ball went through the break point a little bit. Got out a little too wide, got through the break point, lucky to just leave the two pin.
Yeah, good splash for a 9 count. But she'll go back and spare this, no doubt.
It really looks to me like the way the lanes are playing at the moment, you don't want to be playing too much of a swing shot, and that's what Carol's trying to do. She's not as comfortable getting out playing the outside angles as Anne Marie is. I think she needs to try and do that, but while she's still in front, she's probably going to stay inside.
Yeah, she carries a 10-pin lead into this frame. Bearing in mind, though, if Anne Marie Putney goes back and strikes, we're back to a level game.
That's right.
Oh, very confident shot there. That's a very nice line she's shot.
It was a very nice shot. It looks as if she is trying to move further outside. I don't know if she's far enough outside, but at least she is trying to get further out towards where Anne Marie's playing. Anne Marie now looking to double up and bring us back to an even match.
It's getting very close, isn't it, Brenton?
Well, it doesn't get much closer than this, especially if she throws one here. It'll be dead even. And it is.
Wow.
She's just got both lanes wired, hasn't she? She's just not missing the pocket at all.
I'm quite enjoying this match. This is impressive bowling from Anne Marie. She really wants to go out there, and she really wants to get the chance to defend her title as the AMF Cup World Champion.
That's right, and it's a hell of a lot of pressure to have to win the qualifying tournament just to go back to have a chance of defending your title, much less actually defending it. So, yeah, this is just a hell of an effort, win, lose or draw. Now a chance to take a 10-pin lead as she can get up, throw a strike here.
She knew that one was going high.
Yeah, just like, didn't quite get the release right on that one, like a little bit of a double bounce to it.
Yeah, looked like a bit of a loft.
Yeah. But it's a 4-pin. And she's just hitting the pocket all the time. She's giving herself a chance.
Yeah, she's got the best possible chance of taking this repercharge match. She really hasn't missed the pocket. One's been high. Her out of the two, I'd say, are in the best position right now. As we have another look at that scorecard. Now, if Carol gets up and shoots a strike, she brings this game within one pin.
This is, yeah, really, really tight here. A lot of pressure. She's been on television many, many, many times.
Oh, she got it. Oh.
Never quite got it wide enough. Last time up on that lane, the ball hung out a little bit on her. Maybe made a slight adjustment and it just went a bit early. Needs to get up, make the single pin.
She must be getting some sort of encouraging signs to stick with the line she's throwing. One's gone light, one's gone high. Somewhere in between. That's where she's got to be.
I think what she's actually doing, she's just trusting herself and her ability to throw that shot as tough as it is.
And I suppose that's the right thing to do. I mean, if she knows within herself that perhaps she's not getting the shot right, she needs to get the shot right before she makes any adjustments.
Well, you've got to go out there and back yourself. Yeah, I'm in the seventh frame. This is the crucial frame.
Oh, it's in there. Get the mix. Look good.
It looked very good. You think you could say now the past two times up on this lane, she's got this lane pretty much wired. Left the 7-pin.
That 2-pin has carved itself into the side kick and chopped the 4 out, which normally would have taken the 7.
It's basically left us with an even match. Flattens the shot out. Oh, I thought she flattened it out, but she didn't.
Oh, no.
Well, this match has been so close all the way through.
Oh, my goodness.
And look like just a... Have a look at this. Just grabbed so hard in the back end.
You would think the way the lanes have been playing that ball would never be hooking that much. Especially shooting through the middle part of the lane, which is where all the oil is.
So it's unusual because quite often when she's shooting at a spare, she'll flatten it out a little bit. Maybe just didn't flatten it out enough. And that might just be the turning point of this tournament. Anne Marie now, she's jumped on it every time she's had an opportunity.
Oh, that's, she got a fantastic ball reaction there. She had drilled that thing from the get-go.
It's a great reaction, but to get that great reaction, you know, when you've got the opportunity to jump on an opponent, you know, the tendency sometimes to try and overhit the ball or try and steer the ball. She's just gone up there throwing a quality shot.
And now to double this up. Oh, she knows where it's at.
Well, we've gone from an even match to, 21 pin lead all of a sudden.
And with Anne-Marie the chance to add bonus pins the next time she gets up. It could very well turn ugly.
Carol now needs to respond.
Trying to find something out there, but going head high, she's left the 6-9-10.
And the right lane's been hurting her pretty much all match. She really needs to start throwing some strikes now to have any chance in this match.
And she's got to throw this spare, which she's done. Credit to her, very good. But she's really got to go off the sheet now, the way Anne-Marie's been throwing this ball.
I don't think Anne-Marie's going to let up at all. She really needs to get the job done.
Now that's a quality shot. That's much more what we're used to seeing from Carol.
She's definitely found the right lane. She's figured the right-hand lane out. The left-hand lane, she must figure it out in this next frame to have any hope at all. That's if Anne-Marie gives her any hope.
Oh, well, I think she definitely needs some help from Anne-Marie. She needs Anne-Marie to either spare out or leave her an open and hopefully jump on top of that, but I can't see that happening, Brenton.
Well, it would take a hell of a turnaround, I think, in Anne-Marie's mental game more than anything, because she just got such a great ball reaction, just got such a great look on the lane, and the carry percentages are right up there.
And I think she knows that all she has to do is carry this shot, which she's done, and she's going to have that chance.
Well, the way this is looking, I think pretty much all she's got to do now is stay in the building.
Definitely stay behind the foul line and keep it out of the gutter.
That's about the size of it.
She gets up in her 10th frame with a double in hand. Stays behind the foul line. Oh, almost gets that messenger across.
I think by the look of that shot, she's just maybe a little bit hesitant about messing with the gutter on that one. Pointed it up a little bit just to stay away from the gutter.
Yeah, a bit of anxiety, but 6-10 spare coming up.
But with that, she's got more than enough already.
Barring an incredible meltdown, ladies and gentlemen, you are looking at your 2008 SPC champion.
Absolutely, she knows it already. She's in, she's got the title.
And more importantly, she has that chance to double it up at AMF World Cup time.
That's right, that's the important one for her. She wanted to have the chance to go back, defend her World Cup title, become only the second lady to go back-to-back, the first one being another Australian, Jeanette Baker, back in the 1980s.
Throws through the nose for a five count, but that doesn't matter. She's closed out for a very impressive 231.
It's a magnificent game under pressure.
Now look at her, she is excited. She is loving it.
I think you'd safely say she's beside herself.
No, she's done a fantastic job. Carol Giannotti just rolling out this last frame now. And let's just say Carrie has not been on her side.
Finally hits the pocket on the right-hand lane, but far too late, unfortunately. But Carol's a quality player. She'll be back. You know, any time that she makes a cut in the women's tournament, she's always in contention to win. Anytime she decides to shoe it up, the other ladies know they're in for a battle.
Oh, yeah. Having said that, though, if there's any women on the Australian tour right now that I would prefer have us represent Australia, I think it would be AMP.
Oh, I think so. She's just a magnificent performance in this tournament. 231 victory over Carol Giannotti, 190, and she's going back to the World Cup.
Ladies and gentlemen, we get on to the presentations. First of all, just a couple of people I'd like to thank, especially the sponsor, Mike Quitter from Ebonite International. Mike's the Vice President of Ebonite International, and he's part of his company, Columbia 300, put money towards this event. So I'd really like to thank the sponsors. Okay, we get on with the presentations. And finishing in third place from New South Wales, we had Maxine Nabel. And our runner-up from Western Australia, we had Carol Giannotti. And the champion for the 2008 Columbia 300 South Pacific Classic, Anne-Marie Putney. To get your hands together for the champion, Anne-Marie Putney. Now I'd like to present Anne-Marie with a cheque for $1,750.
And a very excited Anne-Marie Putney there, our 2008 South Pacific Classic Women's Champion, and she gets to go back and defend the World Cup title that she won last year. Michael, that was a tremendous performance under pressure.
Yeah, that was fantastic. A 231 score to Carol Giannotti's 190. Was never really out of the pocket, Brenton, until the job was done. She missed the carry on an 8-pin a little bit early, and that would have continued quite a run of strikes coming through. But Carol must be a little bit disappointed with the first game that she faced AMP. She had the chance to finish it all up right there and then, but unfortunately opened a 10th frame.
That was the tournament right there, Michael. Opening that 10th frame with the split, she would have backed herself to get out, throw a good shot in the 10th. Unfortunately, she went through the split, gave Anne-Marie the opportunity to strike out to take it into a repercharge. She did so. And really, after that, Anne-Marie had all the momentum. And then when Carol went and missed that single pin in the 7th frame, that was pretty much game, set and match.
Pretty much, Brenton, I'd have to agree. But AMP, the quality bowler she is, she has come out, done the job in the 10th frame of the first match. She's gone right through, and she is the SPC champion. Until next week, good night.